Hello, today we are going to review the registration process and how you will use this process to schedule for your classes next year. We will review graduation requirements, testing requirements, athletic eligibility, career tech programming, AP and dual enrollment, the drop policy, and how to physically fill out your scheduling card. Your school counselors have all gathered today. I have Mr. McGee to my right, Mr. Wilson, Mr. Lautenslager, and Mrs. Aaron, and well, I'm Mrs. Bowersox. All of the information shared with you today and the course registration bulletin with the full and detailed course description will be available on the PHS website under the Guidance tab. Mr. Lautenslager is going to start off by explaining the graduation requirements.
As you begin scheduling for next school year, you will need to keep in mind Perry High School's graduation requirements. Perry High School requires 21 total credits to graduate high school, and they must be broken down as follows. 4 units of English, 3 units of math for the class of 2013, 4 units of math for the class of 2014 and beyond, which must include Algebra 2 or its equivalent. 3 units of science, including 1 physical science, 1 biological science, and 1 elective science. 3 units of social studies, which must include 1 U.S. history and 1 government, along with 1 social studies elective. A half credit of health, and a half credit of PE, which consists of 2 separate PE classes. 7 additional electives for the class of 2013 will be required, and 6 additional electives for the class of 2014 and beyond will be required due to the extra year of math required. Of the 7 or 6 electives, 1 credit or 2 half credits must be in the area of business tech, fine arts, or foreign language. In addition to the requirements I just covered, students must also pass all 5 areas of the Ohio graduation test in order to graduate high school. This test is first administered in the spring of your sophomore year.
Thank you, Eric. Perry students have the option of enrolling in advanced placement, AP, dual enrollment, and post-secondary coursework. Currently, Perry offers many AP classes. To take these classes, you must be recommended by your teacher and have the AP registration form completed prior to scheduling with your counselor. Dual enrollment courses are college courses taught here at Perry High School. Students earn high school and college credit. French 4 and Spanish 4 are awarded through Kent State University's START campus, and students must complete their college application, which will be available in the guidance office. KSU will make all final decisions regarding student acceptance. All other dual enrollment courses are through Stark State University. Current offerings include English, chemistry, physics, business, and history courses. Students must complete the application and meet the Stark State testing requirements. Stark State will make all final decisions regarding student acceptance. All applications, ACT and Compass testing must be completed and submitted by the time you meet with your counselor. Compass testing will be available here at Perry High School in December and January. Please listen to the announcements for the dates. Students are also able to take college courses on the college campus. In order to have this option, students must attend the college options meeting at PHS. Listen to announcements for information on the meeting date. All of this information is covered in detail in the course registration booklet, available online. Mrs. Aaron, what areas are you going to be covering?
I'm going to discuss athletic eligibility. If you are planning on playing a high school sport, you must be passing 5 half-credit classes in order to be eligible. This eligibility is based on grades from the previous 9 weeks. Physical education cannot count towards your eligibility because it is only worth a quarter credit. Now, if you are planning on playing a sport at a Division I or II college after high school, you need to refer to the NCAA website to learn more about your class requirements. Now over to Mr. McGee to learn more about our career tech programs.
Career technical programs are those that are centered on a specific career field beginning their junior year. Students who are sophomores can look to finish out their high school career studying and working with a specific career field or trade, from cosmetology to the medical field to auto mechanics. There are more than 10 career tech programs to choose from. Career technical students are able to go to college and have the ability to follow a college prep schedule. Many of our career tech programs have college credit opportunities built into the program. Not all programs are housed at Perry High School. In order to provide more opportunities for our students, we have an agreement with Canton South to send students to their programs. In the course bulletin, there are specific course descriptions for programs at both schools. A career tech student's schedule is different than traditional classes. Career tech classes range from 4 to 8 mods per program, and students are only able to take one CT course or program during their junior year. Students who try programs at Canton South will have a blended schedule working between the two schools. Students should also be aware that Project Lead the Way, the High School of Business and Accounting courses also fall under Career Tech as well and are great opportunities to add classes to your schedule without completely changing your school day. There are classes in those programs that are available to all students regardless of grade. As with Career Tech courses, information about these classes are found online in the course bulletin. Now to Mr. Wilson for registration card information.
Let's talk about filling out the registration card. Please take time right now to put your full name on the top of the card. I would ask that you print and use ink. When you make your course class selections, we ask that you use pencil and circle those choices. As you look at the course selections, pay attention to the notations at the end of the course name. Is there an application required? Is it a semester course? Is it open to all grade levels? And is it AP, CP, or a dual credit? Make sure you count up your mods and credits. You should have a minimum of 5 1/2 credits and at least 13 mods scheduled. As was mentioned, if you are in sports, you need to have 5 1/2 credits each semester to be eligible to play that sport. You'll see a box at the top right-hand corner of the card. That is for guidance use only. We'd ask that you not write in that area. On the bottom of the card, please indicate if you are an athlete or if you have an IEP. Also, you need a parent signature before you turn that card in. Finally, make sure you understand the class drop policy that is found in our registration booklet. You have 5 days in the first semester to add or drop classes and 5 weeks to drop a yearly course. You also have 5 days in the second semester to drop a second semester class. Keep in mind that you must have 5 1/2 credits on the schedule for the year.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson. Well, we hope that this has helped you understand the basics to creating your schedule for next year. Remember, colleges look at all the classes you have taken as they appear on your transcript. Colleges and universities want students who challenge themselves in high school. Colleges want to see the following for all 4 years of high school. 4 years of math, science, social studies, English, and foreign language. Your schedule card is due on the date that your teacher tells you after this announcement. Make certain it is signed by a parent, and please sign up to see your counselor if you have any questions regarding your schedule. The course catalog with full and detailed descriptions is found on the Guidance Department website. There will be a limited number of paper copies available to students who do not have access to a computer in the guidance office. Well, we all appreciate your attendance, and we say take care.